you guys right now are out. Tell me how much fun this tour is. You guys are out. You're with Static X, Dope, Devil Driver, Wednesday 13. This feels like the perfect tour for you guys to be on right now.
It is. It's the most. I'm considering it like the most epic tour of the year. So for us to be on it is just absolutely surreal and amazing.
Yeah, I mean, watching your music videos, just the theatrics alone, I feel like you guys are a perfect fit. You guys are opening this tour, right?
Yes.
So I mean, talk about raising the bar early for the rest of the bands. You guys are a perfect. Musically and visually perfect fit for this tour. I mean, how is your stage production going over on this run?
It's been great. It's been very tight. I mean, the production on this tour, the entire tour, every single band has like intense production. So, but we've been able to, you know, they've been gracious. They've been super, super supportive. And we've got our, you know, normally we usually have a lot more in our production, but on this round with five bands on this tour, you know, we limited it to just two pieces of our production. But we've got the lighting behind it, you know, definitely. We didn't do any tracks this time.
Gotcha.
Just kind of keeping things simple, you know.
Right.
But it's still very little with a lot of impact, put it that way.
Awesome. And the whole reason we're doing this interview is the festival I'm looking forward to that is one of the most unique festivals I've ever seen is the Incarceration Festival that's coming up about 2 weeks. And oh my God, I was talking to one of the organizers a week or two ago, and I was like, how did you guys not do this festival sooner than last year? It's perfect. I mean, how excited are you guys to play Incarceration?
We're ecstatic because we heard about it before. We're like, oh my gosh, we want to play that festival.
Yeah.
There's tons of festivals that happen all year, but this was the one that we fit the most. Yeah. You know, we're like, this is the kind of festival we need to play. So when they, you know, when they called us and they, you know, they offered us Tim, we're like, yes, definitely.
Yeah.
And we're huge tattoo, you know, Muppet and I, we all have tattoos, but Muppet and I are like fully sleeve, chest, back, you know, like we're tattooed people. So I'm hoping to get some ink while I'm there with one of the artists. We're super looking forward to it.
I'm sure they'll make that work for you guys. I mean, you're one of the bands. They need to do that for you. I mean, to have it at that prison too. I mean, just the history of that location, everything.
I know. I mean, and we're getting a private tour too, so I'm super excited.
Oh, I'm so jealous right now. I'm taking a tour of it, but to get a private tour would just be.
We're doing a private tour with a photo shoot.
Nice.
So, they're treating us extra special on this one. We're super excited.
So festivals with your theatrics and the visual element to your show. I mean, how does that translate over when it comes to doing a festival set?
Well, you know what? We've always been a little bit nervous about it, especially if we're having like a daytime slot because we're such a horror themed band.
Yeah, it's a little bit darker.
But you know, the show and the way that we, I guess, the way that we deliver our set. It doesn't matter what the lighting is at that point. We're very, very deeply involved with the crowd. So that's definitely something that we do different from some bands and a lot alike, you know, than other bands. I mean, we definitely engage with the crowd as much as possible, you know, despite the barricades and the distance. But, you know, our show and our music really kind of stand on their own.
Yeah, and I can tell you, as somebody that shoots concerts, I get very excited when a band like you guys is having a daytime slot, because shooting you guys in the clubs can be really hard sometimes because the light is so low, so we can finally get some good pictures. Everything. So I mean, that's what I'm excited about. And you guys released the single right before you guys went on the road, which
Risen from the Ashes.
Which I've listened to about 5 times today. My boss, I'm not sure my boss likes it very much, but it's playing. It's playing in the office, and I mean, I've listened to a couple songs today, and just I mean, I love the style. I love the theme. I love everything about it. The music videos are freaking so good. Dollhouse.
Thank you.
Awesome.
Thank you.
But tell me about Rise from the Ashes, and it's coming up from the album that's being released next year. Are we talking about early next year? How does Rise from the Ashes fit in with the rest of the record?
We released our first single from the upcoming album, Carnival.
Yeah.
And that this is definitely our third album. It's our Black album.
Okay.
So it goes in line with our second comic book issue.
Sure.
So I don't know if you know about our first comic book issue, but our first comic book issue basically introduced you to who we were, where we came from, and how we came together as the four individual characters. And our first two albums really mimic the storyline of who we are.
Gotcha.
The third album goes side by side with the second comic book issue, which is We Came Across the Darkness. It's our Dark Black album, and that's the first song was Carnival, which is basically inviting everyone to come to the carnival,
right.
Our Dark Mile Carnival. And then this song, Risen from the Ashes, was it kind of tells you Raven was burned at the stake for
right.
practicing magic in her past life. So this is her discovering herself and rising, obviously, from those ashes. And so it's definitely an inspirational, tribute to her coming to again in this new life of hers, and going through this dark journey with her colleagues. And we're introducing new characters on the second comic book issue. We're excited. The album is, we're trying to release it this fall for this part two of
okay.
the Static X run and Devil Driver, so we definitely are excited. We don't know if we're going to make it in time because we don't get home until August,
okay.
and then we go back out again in November. So if it doesn't come out this fall on that second part of the tour, then we'll definitely be releasing it February, March of 2020.
Awesome. Yeah, I mean, I wanted to ask about the comic book, because with a band and a storyline, it's a very complex operation, and just everything you guys have going on. How important is it to have that comic book where you can go more into the backstory, and because it gives you another platform to kind of explain everything and go into?
Correct. Well, that's the thing, is a lot of, we knew, with the vision that I had and creating the band, and when we formed the band, and this is 2015, we're very young band.
Oh, yeah.
And we've only been touring for 3 years, but it's very, you're right, there's a lot of work going that goes into it, because it's conceptual. So
mm-hmm.
from every song that we write, and we write all the time, but we've written over hundreds of songs, but only 7 or 8 make it to the album, because it does definitely have to follow the storyline, and we want people to understand, why we write the songs, what the meaning is behind the lyrics, why is there costuming, why are we who we are, So it definitely is important. It's a very important piece to the visual, as well as the music.
Yeah, it's interesting. It's really cool. I mean, I've only seen something like this one other time, and it's always really interesting to me. And I wanted to ask, when you were sitting down and putting everything together at the very beginning in 2015, or maybe before, just the Raven Black character and all of the other characters like Muppet and whatnot, where do these come from, and how long did it take to really put everything together and turn this into what it's become?
Well, conceptually, vision-wise, I've had this since forever. Just a story, just being an artist myself. But Raven's character is myself. I mean, so each character is a character I wrote, nicknaming the character, but each band member has given me their backstory of their life. I mean, like in real life, and I have then fictionalized it. From
okay.
their walks of life. So there's some reality to each of our characters.
Gotcha.
And so it's very, very organic. I mean, it took 2 years of just gathering, that part of it and writing the story in my head on paper. And then, of course, to translate it into comic book bubbles was the most probably challenging thing I had to do.
I bet.
And then illustrate it on top of that. so that it's fun and it flows, because comic books are very different from writing a novel.
Yeah.
But yeah, but it's been a fun challenge. I think our fans really love it. The one thing that I do want to mention that is very different that people don't catch right on, you know, first surface value, is that these comic books were created not just because we wanted it, you know, come out with a comic book, but it was my platform and intentionally created in the very beginning to be able to include our fan base, our fans, into our story and be a part of what we are and what we're creating. So, you know, if you look at the music video for 13, it's animated with our comic book characters, and seven or eight of the characters in that music video are some of our super fans in cartoon. So they are memorialized in what we have created and released forever.
Oh, that's awful. I didn't even.
Yeah, and then, yeah, exactly. So until you kind of dive into who we are and you have a comic book and you listen to all the albums,
right,
and you've seen us live, then it kind of all comes together and you go, boom, okay, now it makes sense. But like even in the next issue that we're coming out with, there's at least, I'd say 12 characters who are actual real life fans that I will be writing in to the comic book story. So, and they don't know who they are yet, but they will when they receive and read it. They'll be like, that looks like me, and that sounds like me, and that was a memory, an experience I had with Raven or the Doctor or one of the band members, and go, oh my God, she wrote that into the story. They wrote it into the story.
So,
that's something that, yeah, it goes deeper.
So you're always really, really paying attention to what the fans are telling you, their experiences when you're doing these meet and greets or running it.
Absolutely.
And I feel like that's what's going to even add to the longevity of Raven Black, because when fans aren't stupid. They can figure out when bands or, you know, people that they look up to aren't being real or genuine.
Correct.
About it. But when they feel like you really can connect with that band and the band like actually remembers you when you run into
them
down the road, that's what makes band fans become a lifelong fan compared to just, oh, they're still making music?
You know, correct. I mean, correct.
That's the most frustrating thing for me, is like, I'll be like, oh, I'm going to go see so-and-so. I didn't know they were still making music. It was like, really? Why did I not know that, you know?
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's really cool. And you guys worked with Ulrich on this one, which it's really kind of come full circle because he's worked with Static X.
Yes.
How cool is that?
Oh, it's just, well, when we met him, you know, when we met him years ago, and we met him at the Whiskey Go-Go, we played a show, and he walked up to me, and I was like, I know who you are, like that Deftones, White Zombie, Rob Zombie. I mean, you name it, he's worked with them, and Tool, and I'm just like, oh, some of my favorite bands, some of our favorite, Static X, Wayne Static, he was part of that. As a matter of fact, Andy, he's the kid, Wayne's, you know, guitarist on his solo project, played bass on this last album, 13. So Andy actually recorded bass on this album for us, so... Yeah, so then to find out we're going to go on tour with Static X, where it's just like, and I'm a huge fan. I feel like, you know, I told the guys, I talked to Tony and Ken Jay the other day, and I just told them, I feel like a teenager. Like, like it was yesterday.
Yeah.
You know, you didn't play 20 years ago, 19 years ago. No, this was just like yesterday.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, it's weird how... like 99 was 20 years ago. Now it's like,
it's crazy.
How did that happen? It's like,
no, exactly.
It's like, I'm hearing like Green Day on classic rock radio now, and I don't know what I don't know what to.
What? I know. It's like, weird, right?
Yeah, it's like, but I mean, recording with the guy, touring with the band that, you know, recorded with the guy that recorded you guys. I mean, it really is like things are coming full circle. Which is really cool. But I've got to ask you, being on the Wisconsin Death Trip anniversary tour with all of these bands that, you know, we've all just looked up to for so long, but especially Static X with those guys, how often do you guys sit down and just talk about memories of Wayne and just like, what are these shows like being? They're kind of like memorial shows too, kind of.
Yeah, it's definitely different from all the other tours we've been on, and not to say that not one tour is better than the other, but
right.
Very different experiences, but this one feels very special. I mean, the first night, I got teary-eyed. Yeah. I had goosebumps through the entire night, but how often we were, I mean, they're all so, just very so humble and so down to earth. I have talked to them at least once or twice a day, every day. So, they're just very approachable, very down to earth, just, you know, regular guys. I mean, they're just really cool, very nice. It's not preachy. They're just like hanging out.
Right.
Tony told me a couple of memories about Wayne, and Ken told me about him and Wayne writing some songs, and you know, it's just been really cool to hear those stories. But they're very, very just hanging out. I mean, every day. They're not on their bus. They're not hiding away. I mean,
good.
Yeah, they're super cool.
That's awesome. And how is Zero, the Static Singer? How is he live?
Guys
are coming to Indy on the 11th.
Zero is doing an amazing job, yeah. And he's doing an amazing job. And when you know that it's not Wayne, you think about it. But if you don't think about that, that's Zero, and you're standing there from like center front of the house watching the show,
it looks like Wayne.
It looks and feels like Wayne.
That's awesome.
He's doing an amazing job. He's doing it more than justice. Awesome. I'm so proud. I'm so proud of the fact that, I mean, you could tell he's put his heart into it. And it shows.
That's awesome. And honestly, I don't really even want to know who it is. I'm sure you guys all do know, but I don't care. It's done really well, and they're doing it justice, and the mask is great. I mean,
yep.
it's the way, if they're going to do it, it's the way that it should have been done. And the bands that you guys have out on this run, I mean, this is like the perfect tour package for a tour like this. It's so
cool. Oh my God, I just woke up this morning and I was like, yeah, I'm on tour with Static X and Dumbledore. And, you know, every night, it's been insane energy in the room. The shows have been sold out.
Yeah.
Devil Driver is like, there's just crazy pitting. Yeah. Everyone is sweating. I mean, people are dripping sweat by the time they come to my merch table. It's insane.
That's perfect. And you guys are coming to Indy in about, actually, the night, do you guys play the first day of incarceration? I can't remember.
The second day of Saturday.
Well, I'm going to be seeing you guys twice in a week. So,
yeah,
you guys are coming to Indianapolis July 11th at the Citadel. I've never even been, it's a new venue. I've never been there.
Wow.
I can't think of a better show to make my first show there. But,
oh, that's so cool.
I can't wait. July 11th, you're coming here, and then July 13th, incarceration.
Yep.
Oh, the party's just getting started. It's going to be so
good. Yeah, I mean, gosh, Buck Cherry, those are some of our friends. We're going to be hanging out again.
Yeah, Five Finger, Shinedown.
Yeah, it's crazy. It's an insane lineup.
Yeah, everybody's on that lineup. I'm driving 5 hours for it. I don't even care. Dude, Raven, thank you so much for taking time today. This has been great. Good luck on the road. Stay safe.
Thank you.
Kick-ass shows. And we'll see you in about 2 weeks.
Okay, I'll see you. Look forward to it.
Definitely. We'll see you then.
Okay, bye.
See ya.
Okay, bye.
See ya.